Ah, there's so much going on, love it.
Let me take the wheel, Caesar.
Nice! Oh, that was... I could not plan that any better. Senegal Lake, toward Inferno, finish line.
The sons of Caladon talked a big game about having a showdown, but this has been disappointingly dull.
Boss, you might have a soft spot for that Caesar, but it's their own fault for being so useless.
But dull can be a good thing. At least we won't have to worry about Cinder Lake for
I don't know.
Years.
I feel like that's not... That spark still might be tampered with. Yep, it's causing other crystals to pop up.
What's with all these ether crystals coming out of nowhere?
The ether aggregation catalyst can accelerate the crystallization of free-floating ether particles. This is tech developed by City Enterprises to increase ether production, and it works wonders in the unique environment of Cinder Lake.
Lucius, do you mean you...
That's right, Pompey. I've replaced your spark stone. Cinder Lake will be completely extinguished soon. Oh, and one more thing I almost forgot to mention. When using this catalyst, the nearby ether concentration will skyrocket. Especially for those with a weak aptitude for ether. It will have serious consequences.
Oh no!
Lucius, how dare you?
No!
You won't get away with this!
Not Pompey! Oh shit, you earned that.
How dare you give me another scar! You monster! Despite being so corrupted, you still have this much strength!
To think I ever had such high hopes for you. I was blind!
You sure were. Fucking, there's no way you should have let Lucius out of
here. You understand the impact of colluding with the city's ether companies? What it'll do to this place?
Did you really think we all shared your old-fashioned ideals of freedom and morality, boss?
The weak and the worthless have no place in this age. With the power of ether, I will establish a new order in this leaderless outer ring. A kingdom completely under my control!
You're not fit to fucking rule anything.
What is it?
Boss, we found the Sons of Caladon. They're about to reach Cinder Lake.
What? All those explosives didn't take them out?
We have to retreat for now. Seeing Cinder Lake snuffed out would have been a 90, but now it's down to a 60.
Sorry, boss. Time to say goodbye. At least you'll be out of your misery. Wait a minute.
I just remembered.
Weren't you disappointed you couldn't face the Sons of Caladon?
Oh, you son of a bitch.
Showdown?
You're gonna let your fucking boss get corrupted so you can take out the you're so fucking awful! I hate you, Lucius!
Warning. A significant increase in ether concentration near Cinder Glow Lake has been detected.
What? What's going on? There aren't any cameras near Cinder Lake, so we can't be sure. But it's definitely not a good sign. Damn. Does that mean we're too late?
No matter what, Lucy. We have to get there as fast as we can.
Come on, let's get going.
Taxi? Where are our bikes?
If we should take them to a place not too far away. Come with me. Sari, how's the situation at Cinder Lake looking?
Rising ether concentration levels detected. I have also detected that Cinder Lake's heat signature is shrinking.
I knew it! Cinder Lake is in trouble.
We're almost there. Our rides are up ahead.
Let me at him!
Load up and pull out! Catch this one!
Only champions make history.
No! Damn.
You're so young and nimble.
Good work, Piper.
Fuck out of my way. Wait, aren't these just our bikes? Thank goodness, my old buddy's still good to go. Lucy, ladder. How are your rides holding up? Those are a bit wonky, but they're hanging in there. Mine's good, too. And I got the little pigs are also on screen. All right, let's roll out. Oh, I can't believe this Lucius some moments later. Look at what he's done.
We're almost there. Cinder Lake is just ahead. Caesar, that's...
Old man, hang in there!
The corruption is too severe.
Caesar, something's wrong with Cinder Lake. There are ether crystals everywhere. What on earth happened here?
It's Lucius. He betrayed me.
We'll get you out now. We can deal with the rest
There's
later.
No time. Caesar, listen. You must protect Cinder Lake.
Oh, Pompey, no! Oh my god, he's so too cool! Oh my god, no, that was just the bike. The bike itself got corrupted. That's Pompey. Whoa. Oh my god, this entire boss. Oh shit! Oh, this is like the coolest thing ever!
Hey! Old man!
Where you go?
It's useless. It's completely turned into a material.
He's the one conspiring with the Eagle Corporation to extinguish Cinder Lake!
That's right. So long as the oil runs out. Whatever you choose.
Warning. Rising ether activity detected.
Look!
Jesus! I use my counters on this boss.
Not even close. Come on, face me head on.
Oh, nice timing there. Okay. God damn, such a cool boss fight! Oh, they really thought outside the box with this one. Oh, here we go. He was a sword wielder, so yeah. What's the other thing?
Attack mode has changed. Watch out, everyone.
Out of our way, old man! If this keeps up. Are you guys okay? Either. Don't worry about us. Just think about winning. This is the only way for the enemy to rest in peace. Understood. Leave it to me.
Oh shit!
Just doing my thing.
Get out of there! Shit, I didn't.
Fear nothing.
Oh, there's so much shit happening. I can't tell what's going on. I'm taking way too many hits. Oh, there he goes. It's a good fight, old man. But it's time for you to go. That's my bike! What about the lake?
We finally did it.
But Cinder Lake, in a few minutes it'll be completely extinguished.
How ironic. Even with the spark stone, it's too far away. There's nothing we
What are you talking about? There's that pipe.
Oil. What does Lucius plan to do with the old oil field? Unless a miracle happens.
You got this, Caesar. Come on, Caesar, you got this! Come on, Caesar! You got this! Let's go!
Don't look at me like that. Because I'll start to feel afraid.
Oof, what an ending. You're gonna go down in history, Caesar. Be a legend.
Wait, there's an abnormal spatial fluctuation nearby. It's like something is coming our way.
It's not over yet. Where is it?
Above? Oh, that's how the hero survived the first time. He fell through a spatial tear. Woo, girl, you got some control over that bike.
Yo, we meet again.
That's how the first hero was able to make it through. They have some good stories and animations in this. I fucking love it. 3 days later. But what happened to Lucius, though?
Wise, everything's packed. We're ready to head back home.
Proxy! Good thing you haven't left. I almost missed seeing you off.
Caesar, I told you, you shouldn't have rushed over here. With everything that's happened in the old oil field, you need to be there to keep things under control.
I told you, I'm just the acting overlord. That day, even though Pompey threw in the Sparkstone that was replaced by Lucius, he was the first one to reach the finish line. The overlord title should be his.
I see.
Caesar, speaking of Lucius, any news on his whereabouts?
Nothing yet. We haven't found his man Mors either. That no good snake. We sent Bernice and Piper to cut him off, but he got away.
Damn it, once again, people are getting away from us.
Looking through the stuff he left behind, we found evidence that he was colluding with an Aether corporation in the city. Combined with Eos's recordings that day, the old oil field bikers are well aware of what he did. Proxy, I didn't get to thank you after leaving the Hollow. We saved Cinder Lake thanks to you.
Couldn't have done it without you, Caesar. When Cinder Lake was about to go out, I almost gave up hope.
Yeah. It really was all on you, Caesar. That was one badass thing you
all
did.
All I could do was watch as you rode away, getting further and further from us.
Hey, don't get emotional on me. I was saved by the fisher hidden under the vent. Isn't it crazy how that went down?
Okay.
A friend who's an expert on this said that due to the complex air currents around the fissure, ether particles are unable to stabilize, preventing it from being sealed off. Due to the balance between the natural gas and the ether particles, the fissure won't be moving anywhere. It's probably been there for decades.
Diving into the fiery sea, the hero returns valiantly. When the first overlord reached the lake, maybe that's where he jumped in too.
Who'd have thought the legend of the first overlord was true? Well, this was an unexpected discovery.
Oh, hell yeah.
People back then didn't know about the fissure. And the first overlord probably forgot what happened to him. So that's where the divine intervention part of the legend came from.
I still say I would call the fissure being there, still divine intervention.
True, but isn't the existence of a fissure right in the middle of Cinder Lake?
Yeah, Caesar agrees with me.
Divine intervention-y?
Do you remember what happened after you fell into the fissure?
Parts of it, but it's hazy. I thought I was done for. In the darkness, I thought I would lose consciousness pretty quickly. But I could feel every part of the overwhelming pressure as I passed through the fissure. Then, I saw a light in the darkness, and instinctively pulled back on the throttle and sped towards it. Next thing, I came out right on top of you all.
It was unbelievable. After you said, "We meet again," the next thing out of your mouth was, "Lucy, if I die, the Sons of Caledon are yours."
She's always had her eye on taking over as the leader of the Sons of Caladon. And in that moment, I suddenly realized that I'd never made that clear before. I thought she'd be relieved, but that lunatic jumped up, shouted, "I don't want your leftovers!" and straight up slapped me in the face.
I can't believe they didn't animate that.
That was pretty wild. Lighter and I were at a loss for words.
My face was even swollen the next day. You guys all had a good laugh about it. But this time, I really worried you all. Since you're heading back to the city, let me give you something as a memento.
Ooh. Hey! Oh, okay, so I can probably see it. That's the figure. Got it. I didn't even realize it at first. But it's cool we finally get our own.
Wow, a Sunflint! Yeah. All of the Sons of Caladon chipped in. It's a shame I didn't have time to help with the weaving. I just drew the design in the middle.
Thanks. I'll take good care of it.
You're always welcome in the Outer Ring, Proxy. May you rise from the ashes.
Oh, well. Anyone's feeling bummed about you leaving, Proxy. Why not go and say goodbye? Big Daddy heard about what happened to the Tour de Inferno and over to help me hold down the fort. That doesn't read right. Big Daddy heard about what happened with the Tour de Inferno, and I think he's supposed to be offered to help me hold down the fort. He's eager to meet you. Anything in mind, Proxy? About the old oil field's current situation. Big Daddy said we'd be in for a rough patch. While the oil is flowing smooth, the Vanquishers might go a bit wild with old man Pompey gone. We got to stay sharp. Plus, I know I'm not exactly cut out to be the Overlord. Yeah, thanks. Old man Pompey has sealed the deal with the other districts, so I won't let his effort go to waste. What about Perlman? Yeah, what happened to Perlman? Well, he's improving these days, but he's not fully conscious yet or able to chat. Don't worry, I'll give the others a heads up once he's ready to talk. Okay, so he's still out. Yeah, no worries. Nothing else for now. Let's save. So, we got the character, but where is... Ah! Big Daddy! Goddamn. You're so fucking cool. Anybody down here that we should talk to? Seems like a bit of a... Oh, there they go. Never mind. They weren't real. Nah, it doesn't look like it. Bolter? Huh. Can't drink fuel. Yeah, who? Oh god, I hope my energy drink doesn't actually contain actual fuel. Would you imagine if you actually found out you can run your car on Monster energy drink? I would be like, oh yeah, definitely not. Shouldn't be drinking this. What's up, Big Daddy? Hello, sir. Hey, skip the formalities, kid. Just an old biker here. Good to have some young blood around. Never saw this coming before the Tour de Inferno. I thought Caesar needed more life lessons before she'd really understand. A kid grows up fast, huh? I'd be happy if you wanted to chat with this old man, my young friend. Used to lead the Sons of Caladon? That's right. I'm tired now. Just handling some business stuff. But at the moment, those kids can use a hand. It's not because they're lacking strength or smarts. Because they got to deal with some real dim bulbs. To make things easier, I'll step in to clear the air a bit. God, man, you're so cool. I wish you were in the story more. Don't talk like a typical Outer Ringer. Don't go tagging stereotypes on the Outer Ringers, my friend. We're mixed bag from all walks of life. But you're right about one thing, though. I'm not a native to the Outer Ringer. I'm from Eridu. However, accepted the Outer Ring as my home since all the Zeros swallowed Eridu. Excuse me. No worries, my young friend. I'm sure you got your own stuff to handle. Ah, so he's from old Eridu. You heading back to the city, Proxy? Thanks for all your work these days. You youngs are always buzzing with energy. Hope we'll work together again. Where you been lately? Oh, that's sweet. You've been keeping little me in mind. I've been on the road delivering messages and all. With the incident during the Tour de Inferno and Pompey gone, I need to clear the air before anyone starts spreading rumors. But Lucy ain't nearly as caring as you. She made me visit all the settlements and towns within a week. I'm exhausted. You were fatigued driving, weren't you? Yeah, don't worry. I've handled it already. Little me ain't the same clumsy girl from back in the day. I just wanted to come back in time to say goodbye in person. Thanks for traveling all the way back. We're friends, right? You bikers got a bit of proper farewell. What do you plan on doing next? Well, I'm tied up for a bit. Caesar's all about honoring Pompeii and opening new routes ASAP. Looks like little me will be hitting the roads again. Retirement will have to wait, I suppose. But hey, when the young guns need me, I'll be there. That's weird, Senior Piper. Piper Senpai. Yeah, stop teasing me. You'll make me this little old trucker blush. It's about time I get going. Yep, see ya. You know, I feel like there are people who would just say that and just hit bell and then leave. Like, not even say bye to the character. So that feels so wrong. Lighter, you're so fucking cool. When do I get to pull you? You go home, Proxy? Safe journey back. Say hello to my dear predecessor and brother for me if you got a chance. Tell him I'm free for a duel anytime. You plan to do the next, Lighter? Well, the Motor League may recognize the boss as the overlord on the surface, but there's going to be some who aren't willing to accept it. If they decide to kick up a fuss, I'll be there to teach them how to keep the trap shut. But, of course, don't tell the boss about that. Plus, her being overlord's already making her lose her enough sleep as it is. Expect you to be so thoughtful. Heh, getting paid, so of course I gotta take a load off my boss's shoulders for her. But that's recently I've been thinking. It wouldn't be too bad to just stay with the Sons of Calon as a biker. Boss is truly a leader worth following. Nothing like how I was back then. Heh, it's nothing. So that person you want to do is Billy? Yeah. I heard you two often head to the halls together. You probably already noticed, but this combat skills aren't something just anyone can master. You can say he's practically born for battle. Billy? Really? Yeah, looks like my bro's been doing a good job of hiding his edge. Perhaps to him, he's already got the life of his dreams. Well, I'm off to see you around. You heading back, Proxy? We aced the tour to Inferno thanks to you. Seriously, how much do I need to pay to recruit you into the Sun's Calon? Yeah, no more jokes. Safe travels. You're gonna go back to take a look, Lucy? Back to New Erdu, or back to my home? I'll go to New Erdu when the opportunity arises. After all, I'm the one handling business for the Sons of Calon in the city. Plus, I need to pick up some clothes and makeup. As for my home, my dad still hasn't given up on looking for me. He's reported me missing to public security and plastered wanted posters everywhere. Since he's so intent on this whole find me game, playing along with him could be fun, don't you think? How are you doing with Caesar? What? Did he complain to you? Still mad about the slap? Eh. Caesar realized her slip up. I couldn't care less about what that boar thinks. But for now on, Sons of Calon will put personal grudges aside. Caesar needs to solidify her position as a new overlord. Big Daddy and I will bring her around. To just so her new role quickly. Lighter knows what to do if things get messy. We got everything covered. I'm leaving. Take care. Thanks. See you. Did I actually finish talking with, Oh! Almost forgot about Bernice. Oh, yeah. There were things on here. About the old oil field's current situation. Big Daddy will be in for a rough patch. While the oil is flowing smooth, the Vanquish just might get a bit of a... Old man Pompeii going. Oh, okay. We already done this. Okay, we did. I can't forget about the drink master here. Headed back to New Erdu already, Proxy? Safe travels. Where are you headed next? Back to our camp on the freight station. You were curious about our camp, Proxy, so why not tag along? But I gotta look after my video store. Oh, I almost forgot. Stay here too long and your bamboo home will worry. What's more, your heart's with New Erdu, Proxy. Just as, where would the outer ring? Yeah, Bernice, come visit our store. You want a membership? Sure, let's hit the drink shop together. When I went to the Caesar last time, we were putting food in the drinks. Oh, we'll be throwing a party to celebrate the Sons of Calon taking the throne. Don't forget to swing by. I'll definitely be there. Bernice, then I'll go tell Caesar. You gotta come, okay? Catch you later, Bernice. Catch you later, Proxy. I kinda like Bernice. I like her fighting style. I like how when you finish a combo, you can just when you do finish a regular combo, you can just end by pointing both flamethrowers out and just incinerating your opponent. It's so satisfying. Should we head out, Wise? Yeah, let's head home. Caesar mentioned they take us near Erdu, so we just need to focus on driving. The car window seems like an endless scroll painting, and with the car's movement and bumps, the desolation of the outer ring slowly turns into the colors of New Erdu.
The sound of Caesar's motorcycle has completely faded. It looks like we're about to leave the outer ring.
As expected of the new overlord, so reliable. It's really cool that they escorted us all the way to the edge of the outer ring. They even took a bunch of shortcuts that the GPS didn't know.
Thinking about how Cinder Lake was almost extinguished, and now we're laughing and driving home, it feels like a dream.
Yeah, and an entire people's way of life was almost just ruined. God, I hope I can beat Lucius up.
What's wrong, Belle? You sound a little emotional.
Although we could only prove the fissure in Cinder Lake exists from its effects, apart from Caesar's bold gamble, there really was no other way to save it. But watching Caesar fall, that feeling of helplessness, I never want to go through that again. Just like that time.
Hmm? Oh, right. Their weird past.
Belle.
Wise. No wonder we're family. You must be thinking the same thing I am.
It's right interesting. Now. It's interesting that these are our main characters and we don't know their backstory.
This is the edge of the city. Eos and Fairy are here too. It's time.
Silently turning the steering wheel, the random place service signal turns into a road away from the main avenue. Ooh.
Master, you have deviated from your course, recalculating a new route home.
Oh, are you visiting a grave?
Don't worry, Fairy. We are going the right way. The road we're taking now is the real way home.
Hmm. The car follows the city's edge, heading into quieter and quieter areas. The road signs show fewer routes options as they go, eventually leaving only one destination. Towards the ruins of the old capital, at the edge of the castle.
We're here. Let's go up.
Come on, Eos. Don't forget your scarf.
No.
Ooh.
It feels like we haven't been back in a long time, Belle.
Fairy, do you know where this is?
Search complete. This is the center of the chasm at the edge of New Erdu. The chasm, which preceded New Erdu, was the product of the large uncontrolled hollow disaster in Erdu, often called the Fall of the Old Capital.
Damn, did that first hollow that created a chasm as well? Well, I was thinking we were going to a grave, but looks like we come to a memorial wall. I guess it's close.
To deal with the out-of-control Hollow Zero during the fall of the old capital, Eridu's leaders at the time detonated the 14 Shuryu pillars from the southwest to the northeast.
Whoa! Okay.
The power of the explosion sparked a strong geological chain reaction, bringing about the formation of the chasm.
That's right. There's nothing in the chasm that can be corrupted, so Hollow Zero can't convert more etheric energy to expand, which prevents it from getting out of control.
Ah, okay.
New Erdu could only be built because of it. Without it, if you keep driving from here, you'll end up on the road to the northern side of Erdu, which is really close to the throne quarter.
Within
10 minutes, you'll come upon a massive statue.
That belongs to the White Star Institute. Turning left before the statue takes you to the former main road number 7 of the Minerva Quarter. On the left side of the road were all the old civilization antique shops that Wise liked to go to. He was just a kid back then, and always fell for fake antiques.
And on the right side of the road were all the dessert shops and snack stores that Belle loved. I couldn't resist Belle's whining and ended up buying more treats than she could ever finish.
I couldn't finish them? As soon as any snacks were placed on the table, everyone would grab them up within a minute. Or have you forgotten?
How could I forget? So, at the end of main road number 7, after you pass 3 security gates, you'll see a beautiful building.
Our teacher is right there. She'll be at the entrance with Eos, waiting for us. She always liked to stand to the right of the building's plaque.
The Helios Academy. That's our real home.
The Helios Academy?
It's there now as well, just across the chasm, deep inside Hollow Zero, under the rubble of the old capital's ruins.
Teacher,
We're back. It's been a while this time, and a lot's happened.
The wind carries away her unfinished words. Belle Piccolo-Bayos approaches the protective fence. The bamboo stretches out a small hand and ties a red scarf to the middle net. The colorful cloth dances in the wind.
Master, second assistant, please allow me to express my condolences for the significant individual who has passed away. Should you wish, I can search for her name and accurately determine her location on the memorial monument.
Carol. Carol Arna.
That name was not found in the database of victims from the fall of the old capital. Only one matching result was found in the related information. Resulted in the uncontrollable Hollow Zero, leading to the great tragedy of the fall of the city. The main culprit, Senior Research Director Carol Arna of the Helios Academy, along with others involved, will forever be etched on the Pillar of Shame.
Wait, what?
Speculation. The name provided earlier was incorrect, or the matching information belongs to another person with the same name.
No, it's no mistake. The person officially responsible for the fall of the old capital is Carol Arna.
She was our teacher.
What happened? What did she do?
She taught us, raised us. The HDD system and EOS are among her many achievements. She also saved us when the old capital fell. Very. Didn't you ask us why we wanted to investigate Hollow Zero? This is our reason.
We became proxies so we could collect enough observation data to one day head back to where Helios Academy once stood, deep in Hollow Zero.
Oh shit, that's gonna be one hell of an update.
We're confident that if there are clues anywhere, it's got to be there.
Belle and I are prepared to swear on our lives that our teacher isn't the one responsible. We have to uncover the truth about the fall of the old capital and clear our teacher's name. She's innocent, because...
Warning, an unknown entity has been detected nearby.
Huh? Now? Who would come here?
Oh, hello.
You're the head of Section 6, Hoshimi Miyabi.
That's correct. And you're the leaders of the independent investigation team with the exceptional guide Bangbo. I did not anticipate being bested by you.
We're honored you remember us. But being bested by us, what do you mean?
I am training to be the first to reach the Chasm Memorial. I would like to spend some more time with her alone.
Miyabi goes straight to the monument by the protective fence and softly touches one of the names inscribed on the surface.
So you're here to pay your respects to the deceased too?
Yes. My mother.
My condolences. I hope you can find peace soon.
Thank you. But I don't intend to find peace.
You don't want to find peace?
Indeed. I shall not seek peace until all those responsible for the fall of the old capital are apprehended.
Wait, what? She looks over with a piercing gaze as something quietly burns within the depths of her crimson pupils.
I'll catch them all. None will escape me.
Whoa! Ooh. That night. With the dust settled, we all gotta do now is wait for Perlman to wake up. If our suspicions are correct, the mastermind behind Perlman wants the sacrifice hidden in the monument. The activity from the sacrifice can cause disruptions to smart crystalline lens. Could the sacrifice have something to do with Helios Academy? How do the mastermind and the monster and the fall of the old capital tie together? Yeah, our enemy went after PubSec officer and even hijacked the core airship. They're not folks we can handle alone. Luckily, we got some solid allies. Absolutely. The Cutting Hairs, Bellabog Heavy Industries, the Victoria Housekeeping Company, the Sons of Kalan, and maybe even Shuyan and Kingi. Them on our side, we're not doing this solo anymore. Second assistant, you forgot to mention the most reliable and powerful AI companion in all of New Erdu. How could I forget about you, Fairy? Thank you for your trust, Master. I'm here to help as always. Oh man, that was a bit cheesy, you two. It's late now, and I got the store on tomorrow. Let's head to bed. Good night, Belle. Tour the Inferno completed. And with this night, we officially end it. Settle in and close your eyes. For today, you hardly ever talked about what happened back then. None, even between you and your sibling. The memories are fresh. Like, teacher, we have already. It's morning already. Might have dreamed, but it's all a blur now. New days ahead of good rest. Let me see if I can. Can I do anything on the memory board? I hate how big the memory board is, and we're not allowed to, like, add more pictures. That's it. This is the max amount of pictures I can add. Oh, there's not one for this, like, the Sons of Calon? Ugh. See what Belle wants. Eh? Claim. Tour de Inferno. I think I'll save... Aeos? 18? Don't worry, I think we'll be fine. Why are you being all sneaky, Belle? Oh, why is you awake? When 18 opened the store earlier, there was a bunch of hand people outside. Almost made me jump. Hand people? They looked chill like they just finished a mission. Now I'm really curious about the details of their operation. Me too. Why don't you go check it out, Wise?